That's where I got it from, and of course, that's what I do, and that's what we've been doing a lot of. That's why he's excited about it right now. Feel like he's like getting. He said, "This, you know what? This is exactly what I need."
Yeah, but it's different, right?
Right, it's completely different.
Jonathan, if you're working that circular pattern, you're taught to throw one punch over and over again. You kind of fight. You start to become that rhythm, right?
Exactly.
Like you become acclimated to that.
Exactly. And the hallway always said that when it comes to these big punches, I'd rather work with a guy who can't punch because he's throwing multiple punches,
right,
than a guy who feel he can't punch because he's always going to throw that one punch at a time. Now, given a fight, we all seen the Fury and Wilder fight. Fury's not a puncher. He realizes, he knows it. He was the more active fighter. Every single round, he was active. But Deontay was at a point where he said, you know what? I may not be as active, but I got something I can land. And the luck of the draw, for him, Fury got, for somehow, he rose back to his feet in that last round. But most big punches are not active punches.
They're over reliant
right.
on one weapon.
On one weapon. And one thing I can't stand is walking to the ring with one way to win. I don't like it.
Jonathan, when you got the call to train Klitschko, how do you compare that to this?
Well, it was given the fact that I didn't have the communication with Chibuzi that I have with Klitschko. I met Klitschko in 2004. And Emmanuel introduced me to him. We started sparring and stuff like that. So we had a huge chemistry of doing strength and conditioning and everything over like years and years and years. You know, so that was a little bit different. That was more of a personal, like it hit me on a personal level than just like, you know, a business level because of the relationship I had with him. But still was surprised. You know, I still was completely shocked that,
and
you know,
didn't
that he called.
Did it surprise you?
I was surprised. But, you know, once again, it was different with Vladimir because Vladimir, he was like a big brother to me.
Is there more pressure in this job than the other previous high profile gigs that you've gotten, Jonathan?
For me, no. I mean, this is boxing. This is my life. This is what I do. So now, if Ellie sat back, called and told me he wanted me to fix his tooth, then yeah, that's a lot of pressure because I've never done dentistry work. I put the tooth out before, but I don't know if it was the right way, the wrong way. But I look at it, as long as it's under the umbrella of boxing, I'm full steam ahead.
Jonathan, how was this kept a secret for two weeks? Because everyone was talking, everyone was speculating. Like, did you guys go through back doors? Did you have underground tunnels to the gym? Did you have to put like a mask on as you walked into the gym?
You know what? I think I was one of the last persons on people's mind that it didn't matter what I did because no one in 150 mile radius would have thought about Jonathan Banks. So it was actually easy. It was easy for me not to say nothing or to say something because it wasn't thought of anyway.
Plus you guys were up in Big Bear as opposed to
Correct.
Like more open places in LA.
What are some of the you talked about?